Two new statutes in the news reveal what many pro-freedom folks have been saying for years. The island paradise of Hawaii is becoming an Orwellian political dystopia, and they prove that the government of the Aloha State is rabidly antagonistic to the most fundamental of human rights. Aloha, comrades. I'm Gardner Goldsmith for MRCTV, and here is the information for you. On July 11th, Chris Eager of Guns.com reported that, no shock, Democrat Hawaii Governor David Ige, that's Ige, not Iggy Pop, decided that he would sign into effect two new anti-gun statutes that not only infringe on the right to keep and bear arms, they also stand as insults to logic and common sense. The first is called SB 600, and get this, it prohibits anyone under 21 from entering the political boundaries of Hawaii while in possession of a firearm. It uses the process of discrimination, which isn't necessarily bad. I mean, all human beings, all living animals have to discriminate between two or more things to survive, but it uses it in a political sense in order to selectively punish people under 21. And by the way, already in the state of Hawaii, you are prohibited from buying a firearm if you are under 21. And so SB 600 stands as a giant middle finger to the Second Amendment and the Fourth Amendment, the Fifth Amendment. It also breaches the Sixth Amendment and laughs in the face of the Eighth Amendment. In fact, SB 600 also stands on volcanic legal grounds when it comes to the Full Faith and Credit Clause of the Constitution, which is Article 4, Section 1, which ensures that any legal document or license from one state must be recognized in all states. Now, we shouldn't even have to get licenses to get guns, but this is extremely important. You're supposed to be able to be accepted in all states if you've got a license for a firearm. But Governor Ige and his pals in Hawaii don't want to recognize this. As Todd Yugataki of the Hawaii Firearms Coalition said of SB 600, any person under the age of 21 can join the military and die for their country, drive a car which can be far more dangerous than a firearm and is not a constitutional right, and be an adult making life decisions. However, those supporting this bill do not believe these good people deserve the constitutional right to keep and bear arms. And Mr. Yugataki is right. In fact, not only do so-called bans on guns not stop criminals who are intent on getting guns from getting them, the fact is far more people die in auto accidents each year. As I noted in my written piece for MRCTV, in 2017, the year with the most complete studies thus far conducted, 53 vehicle occupants and 5 pedestrians were killed in Hawaii auto accidents. And that doesn't include the 21 killed due to moped and scooter crashes and the 4 killed in bicycle accidents. That's 83 total, compared to 39 firearms deaths that year in the state, most of them suicide, in a population of 1.63 million. In fact, for 2017, Hawaii ranked second among all U.S. states for traffic fatalities, and the numbers keep rising. And all of those practical data points are really irrelevant when considering the fact that self-defense is an inherent human right, and rights are supposed to be untouchable by the state. Which brings us to the second wonderful statute that Governor Ige signed, SB 1466, the Hawaiian Red Flag Bill, or the Gun Violence Protection Order, similar to what so many collectivists, Democrats, Republicans, and independents have passed in 17 states and proposed in 6. It would allow for co-workers, educators, medical professionals, or family members of an individual thought to be at risk of hurting themselves, sick, or others to ask a family court in the state for a GVPO, Gun Violence Protection Order. If granted in a hearing that doesn't require the subject of the order to be present, the individual would have their gun rights suspended for a year. So as I noted last year about a Massachusetts statute that was very similar to this Hawaii statute, this law allows agents of the state, backed by guns, by the way, to steal from people twice. First, The state will get people's tax cash to pay for the politicians, bureaucrats, and police who will be threatening them. And second, the state can now take people's guns without trial. These are actions that Governor Ige and his agents of the state will take without allowing people to be in a courtroom in front of a jury of their peers. They are so monumentally offensive to the concept of natural rights and common law as to remind people about the sham of government. We are told that government is formed to protect us and our property from encroachments by others. And yet, the state is the entity that tells us it can always take our stuff and threaten our lives in order to carry out its functions. The only way the state can exist is by threatening and encroaching on your rights. And the people in government tell you they're there to protect you. It's bogus, it's false, and Hawaii is exposing this. Please spread the word. This is a very important story. And as I said, this is happening in state after state after state. At least we can learn something from it as we remind our friends what is happening out there. Thanks so much for caring about these principles, and please spread the word. For MRCTV, I'm Gardner Goldsmith.